Good morning. I'm Mark Allen Adams. I'm the owner and the founder of the Mark Allen Adams team. We are Orlando's premier short sale group, and today is Wednesday, January the 19th, 2011. And on today's episode, I want to talk a little bit about documentation. And the reason I want to talk about documentation is because a lot of people have trouble coming up with and producing all the documentation necessary to successfully complete a short sale. So, if you are contemplating a short sale, the very first thing that you should do is collect this list of documents and provide it to your lender or most likely the realtor or the real estate agent that is doing your short sale. So the first thing that you're going to need to provide is the most recent mortgage statement. And that mortgage statement needs to have everything on it, your account number, your name, and your address. The second thing you're going to be asked to provide is a hardship letter, or what I prefer to call a hardship paragraph. And basically, this needs to be handwritten, preferably, and it needs to just give a short synopsis of your issue or why you're pursuing a short sale, the hardship. If you've lost your job, you know, state that. If you've got a job transfer, you know, state that. But it needs to be brief and to the point. Do not make it a full page and a long drawn out thing, because it will not get read. It just needs to be a very quick, brief description of your situation. The next thing you're going to need to produce is the last three payment, the pay stubs or pay statements, whatever you get at your job. Provide the last three or four, preferably four. If you are self-employed, you're going to need a six-month profit and loss statement. The next thing you're going to need to be providing is your tax returns, and do not submit your W-2s. Your W-2s will be rejected. You're going to need your 1040s. The first two pages of your 1040s is basically a summary of your taxes, and that's what you're going to be asked to provide. Bank statements. You're going to be asked to provide 3 months of bank statements, and these bank statements, not just the front page, but your entire bank statement, all of your transactions. They're going to want to see where all your money's going. And I know this seems kind of invasive, but they're going to demand it. If you're going to pursue a short sale, the banks are going to want it. Your lender's going to want it. So it's a good idea just to keep all these documents together in one place, because a lot of times what happens is they're going to say that they never received it, or they're going to ask if you have multiple lenders, you know, every lender's going to want a copy. And so it's a good idea to collect these documents and just keep them in a safe place. If you're continuing to get bank statements and paychecks, just keep your pay stubs up to date, keep your bank statements up to date, set them aside, put them someplace, because chances are you're going to be asked for them more than once. There's several other documents that you're going to be asked for, and you can get a full list of documentation in our short sale package. Immediately to the right of this video, there's a link that says get the short sale package. Click on that link. We ask for your name, address, and phone number, and this is not to spam you or hard sell you or anything. This is just to be able to touch base with you and make sure you don't have any more questions, or all of your questions have been answered. We're just here to educate and make sure that you go into this thing with eyes wide open, and that's just how we do things. So go ahead, get the short sale package, and in that package you'll find that list of documentation, plus there's more documentation there depending on who your lender is. So go ahead, get the package now. And once again, I'm Mark Allen Adams, owner, founder of the Mark Allen Adams team, Orlando's premier short sale group. Have a great day.